Welcome to this series where I'm reviewing a couple of common rookie mistakes in SOLIDWORKS and how you can avoid them. And today I'm talking about using the parameters window to define your sketches and why smart dimensions are really going to be a much better option. So I just made this simple shape here, and something I see a lot of beginners do is they will click on an entity like this vertical line and then come right over here to this parameters box. So let's say we want this to be 5 inches. I'll type 5 and enter. And we can see that that pushes that change out to the sketch. However, this does not fully constrain that entity. In fact, if I come over here and just drag on this point, I can resize the sketch and adjust it. If I click on this vertical line again, we can see it was never constrained to the 5 inches that I entered before. Similarly, if I click on this top arc, it'll put me into this box to define the radius. There's other boxes to define the center points and the angle of the endpoints of the arc, but none of that is going to actually lock down that entity. What you need to do instead is utilize smart dimensions, which fully constrain the sketch using dimensions that are left on the screen that you can modify. So I'll click on this vertical line here, click to place the dimension, and then enter that 5-inch value. So we can see it resized that entity, and we also have this 5 that's just left behind so that I know how it actually is constrained. Same thing with this arc on the top. I'll click to place a dimension to define that. Maybe we'll make this 3 inches radius, and we can see that is now fully constrained. All of the entities in my sketch are now black instead of blue, which means I can no longer drag to adjust them. So if I click on one of these points and drag it, can try again down here, nothing is adjustable anymore. We can also see that the sketch is fully defined, which again just means that there's nothing left for interpretation and that everything is fully constrained. If I need to modify one of these dimensions, I can do so just by double clicking on it, and I can enter a new value, and you can see that sketch update. So don't be a rookie and just lose your parameters as soon as you type them in that parameters window. The Smart Dimension tool is your friend. And we'll see you in the next video tech tip.